Hey, what's up, everybody? Back. It's Thanksgiving. Happy Thanksgiving, everyone. Let me tell you a little bit more about this guitar. Chris from the Les Paul Forum, back when I was having a lot of trouble with my mom and she was sick, and he lent me this guitar because I had no guitar, and I've asked to send it back, but he's been kind enough to let me use it, so I've been having, it's, you know, saved my life as far as being able to keep playing, because I sure wouldn't have anything if I didn't have this. I got this in my pig nose, and pig nose, just a little regular pig nose, it's camouflage. But it sounds great, man. It records really well, too. So anyway, at least I got something to play, you know. I see all these other people, see the Hurricane Sandy people, and let me tell you, I'm one of the lucky ones. Sort of woody tone. I like it, man. Sort of a cross between a Tele and an SG. I guess it's probably not mahogany, but it looks like a mahogany style body, and it's got a maple neck for sure, and some kind of rosewood fingerboard. You know, typical sort of a Gibson setup with the four you know, pots and the three-way switch and a stop tailpiece with an AVR1 type bridge. So a bass player and another guitar player and maybe even a keyboard player, and so you don't all want to hit the root at the same time. It'll sometimes it can clash and sometimes it can make things sound muddy. So a good thing to do is just maybe play the top three strings of your guitar, you know, little triads. And so I do that a lot with my rhythm. Like for instance, if we're in C here, I won't play all the way down. I'll just sort of stop it maybe at the fourth string. Top three strings, and that frees me up, and I can just play it with my index finger and do like cool stuff like a slide, like, you know. So here's our one, now to our four, right here, and then back to our one. Now up to our five. You know, or you do the bottom few strings. You don't want to, the point being, you don't want to have to play a whole chord over, like, say, your piano or, you know, the other instruments, and it won't clutter things up as much. Guitar player playing in a position, let's say down here at C, then maybe you'll want to take the C back down here, you know, so that you're not both playing at the same spot on the guitar. And again, it's just to kind of give it a more interesting background and not make it so cluttered. And I think it lets all the band members hear better too. So here's a C7 down here, you know, or you can play your C, you know. Pickup, then maybe you want to play the neck so that it gives it a little more contrast, makes it interesting. I always be thinking when you're up there playing too, you know, don't just kind of play it safe all the time, you know? You want to make things interesting for the listener and pique their ear, pique their hearing. That's pique with a P-I-Q-U-E, I believe. Anyway, those are just little things. I'm sure you guys probably know all that. I'm not trying to tell you something you don't know, but just things that come to my mind that I can impart to people that might not know.